Hello, Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I am going to describe why on the mosque you see moon and star. And Islam stands for the submission to the will of Allah. And Allah is the primary source of light, which stands for sun. Not for the moon. Moon is the secondary source of light. But why on the mosque they display moon and star? By the way, star is the one which is five-cornered, not six-cornered as the Jewish David's cross. It is the Bethlehem star with five corners. So this is quite easily understood if you know the nature of the Gentile. This has been described by the Gospel of St. Philip, who say, you know, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. Never dies means that he is spiritually alive. So he does not live to die mean that his life is more spiritual and not secular so much. Or he works, you know, but his mind is in God. So this is well demonstrated by the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person. So when he picked up the wounded person, he did not ask him what tribe you are, what is your name, away from you come. But he just picked him up like a human being, as you have mercy on a fellow human being. Then he looked after him. And he paid for his medicines or look after. And he did not ask the man to pay him back. That is philanthropy he did to the man. Philanthropy, as I stress, belongs to the regime or the kingdom of royal kingdom of God. So these Samaritans are Gentile. They were highly spiritual people against these rabbis and Pharisee and Sadducee, who were mostly men of letters, dead in spirit. So that's why the people in Jerusalem, they didn't appreciate what the message of Christ Jesus was, because they were spiritually dead, they could not understand it. And their ears were waxed, and as Christ Jesus has stated, that they were spiritually deaf people, whereas the village people, they were spiritually alive or better. The people of the Judah tribe, they were the worst of all, because this dark age belonged to the people of Judah tribe, as King David used to be a spiritual man. The opposite happened in this dark age. So most of you have seen these symbols on top of the mosque, which is moon and star, and the reasons are hardly known to any. Islam of Allah is the submission to the will of Allah. Allah is spirit and the primary source of light, like the sun. Moon is not the primary source of light, but a witness to the light, as John the Baptist of Levi tribe was. You know, John the Baptist was the priest of Adam. In Adam, you know, we have the priests which are of certain tribe, because they have to handle the children. They should not misguide them. and they are all men, no woman. No woman is allowed to teach. The rabbis in the Samaritan villages were of the Levi stock too, but they were freemen, not under the domination of the Jerusalem temple priest. In Jerusalem, these temple priests were having a domination over their rabbis, and even in the villages they had some rabbis who were under their domination. So they were no more free but slaves. As today you have under Pope so many people under his organization. They are all slaves to Pope. So they are not free men. So in Jesus we are free men. Jesus has set us free in spirit. So we enjoy that freedom. Whereas these people who are paid in Mammon, they have no right to enjoy freedom. If they raise their ears, then they are rebuked by their bishop. So rabbis under the domination of the temple priests were not free men, but slaves. As today you see these dog-collared priests, bishop, etc., are slaves to their superiors, who are their paymasters. Remember the church elders and all that, which Christ Jesus foretold about these things in Matthew 12:43-45, that the house he cleansed, the evil spirit came back and took over. And he bring in seven more evil spirits with him. Seven are the deacons, church deacons. And the situation became worse than it was before. That means before the only rabbi was their master putting the yoke on. And today you have these church elders also putting the yoke on. So the situation had become worst. So today you see a lot of darkness. That is, they are not working for God but Mammon. So those priests who are paid in Mammon, they don't love God. They love Mammon. To attract Mammon, they have become psychic, pleasing people so that they can get more support. This is the legacy of the satanic Messianic Jews, especially of the Judea region, who first expelled the apostles from their churches and replaced them with presbyters. Remember how the Christianity became corrupt? That these Messianic Jews who become the bishops and occupy the churches, they expelled the apostles who were sowing the seed of his word, roving preachers. Remember that what applied to flesh, the opposite to the things of spirit. The teachers of the moral laws, which pertains to the flesh, they are not roving. They are one sitting in the synagogue, like the owner of the house. Whereas those who are of the spirit and who preach gospel, they cannot be living in a particular church or anything, but they keep on moving. They come, sow the seed of his word, and move on to the next church. So they are roving preachers of God, or the royal priest of God. So these people of the Judea region, the people of Judea tribe especially, they pushed the apostles out, they corrupted the church, and by the end of the first century, the church had become so much corrupt that the apostles used to rebuke them, and they told the apostles not to come, and the monks used to taunt them, and God bless you.